Hi guys, Matt from NTrack here. I wanted to make a quick video on how to create an audio sample from MIDI tracks and then look at some of the issues that might occur when editing that audio file. Here, I'm using the NTrack Studio app on iOS. It's going to be exactly the same for Android users. I'm setting up two MIDI tracks now, one Rhodes instrument, one square lead synthesizer instrument from the NTrack software instrument packs. The metronome is set to 120 BPM, and I'm using a USB keyboard to record directly to the phone. I want to record to both MIDI tracks at the same time, so I'm going to arm the second MIDI track, and the record button on that second track has gone red to show it's armed. We've recorded the MIDI, let's turn it into an audio track. Select the three horizontal lines from the bottom right of the app and then mix down from the pop-up. Name it, save it, and we can re-import it back into the session by selecting Import Audio and then the file name that you just named and created. Let's get rid of the MIDI tracks, we don't need them now, and here's how the audio sounds. We've successfully captured the MIDI as audio, let's move on to the editing. Click and hold the audio file to bring up the edit menu, and I've selected the slice tool. The slice tool allows you to break apart an audio file, as you can see here. It's great for creating loops and samples, but listen to this. Can you hear those clicks? If we were to keep them in this production, it would sound a bit amateur. Let's take another listen and then fix it. Okay, so to fix this, I've zoomed into the same audio track and I've selected the fade widget in the top left-hand side of the audio file. I've dragged it right, it's gone green. Let's hear how it sounds. And without. And with the feed widget one more time. You can hear it takes out the click. Let's see what happens when we create a crossfade. I've prepared two slices in the audio file as you can see, and I'm going to remove that section of the track. I can drag another part of the audio file in its place. You can see as the tracks cross, a green fade is created automatically. And in this way, you can modify the original recording and arrangement. For example, you could strip out a chord within a progression, as I'm doing here. Now listen to this. Bit of a click, sloppy ending to the sample. We've already gone over using the fade widget like this. But there's another way. You can select the Draw Volume Envelopes tool from this menu to get complete control over the volume of every part of the audio track, meaning you can make any part louder or softer. Let's hear an example. You can create a green circle just by clicking on the audio track, and yeah, I'm sure you can hear the control in volume in the last example, how it went louder and then softer. I hope you enjoyed those tips on how to edit audio in the mobile version of NTrack and how easy it is to create an audio file from MIDI channels. As ever, please like, share and comment on this video. We read the comments and we'll try to answer as many as we can. In the meantime, have fun making music. Cheers, bye.